and welcome to my channel Spark Stenographer. Today I am going to deliver you a shortened dictation from Kailash Chandra magazine volume number 13 and the transcription number 283. So guys, ready for the dictation? 5 seconds, 10 seconds. Start. Mr. Deputy Speaker, I am glad that different sections of the House have stated their views on this very important problem. I am glad this subject has come before this House and also the other House. I can readily and immediately assure all sections of the House that the government is not only interested, is not only sympathetic, but is also anxious to take action in the matter. I made that position very clear when the Industrial Disputes Act was discussed in this House as well as in the other House. I had stated clearly that the government was anxious to see how best it could bring the working journalist within the scope of the Industrial Disputes Act. In fact, sir, when the Times of India workers case came before this House in the form of a short notice question, I immediately tried to do my best and tell the employers that whatever the definition be at the present moment about which we are carefully looking into, the employers should give the same benefit to the working journalist though they do not come within the purview of the definition or though there are doubts whether they come or not. I am happy to say that the employers have agreed to my suggestion and are trying to carry out the suggestion, namely giving the advantage of the benefit to the working journalist also. No doubt a case has been referred to by my honorable friend, the mover of the resolution, and I have made a promise on the floor of the House. I made a promise to that gentleman who came and meet me, and immediately the government had written to the employers as to why this case was made an exemption. I hope I will hear from the employers. Shri T.N. Singh is a member of the Press Commission over which Justice Raja Diksha presides. I have very great respect for the chairman because he was the adjudicator in many important disputes between the employers and the workers, and his judgment was much appreciated by the workers and the employers. I have anticipated the amendment moved by the honorable friend who desired that the Press Commission, if it wants to go into this matter, should inform us too of its interim finding by the 15th of January. At my request, my honorable colleague Dr. Keshkar has already informed the Commission of this. Dr. Keshkar has also stated that it is my humble view that the Industrial Relations Bill should come up and is expected to come up near early, and therefore we would like to have their view before the end of January. That also we have made clear to the Commission, and I do hope that the Chairman of the Commission and the various gentlemen of the Commission who are there will consider this request and will acceded to the request made by me on behalf even of all the different sections of this house. Anyway, in the last 3 or 4 months, the working generalists have made a great headway by bringing forward their issues before both these honorable houses. And I am sure it is great education to the employers. Another point has been placed before the House by my honorable friend Mr. T.N. Singh and some others, who said that there was victimization or fear of victimization if these working generalists appeared before the press commission and gave evidence. I want to appeal to the employers, knowing as they must the view of the government to protect the interest of the working generalist, that they should take a democratic view of things, and they should be pleased that their employees who are working generalists are given the right to appear before the press commission to express their views, as much as employers who desire to express their views in support of their continuance. I therefore appeal to the employers not to become nervous, not to become shy, not to become angry with their employers because they would like to appear before the commission. I want to appeal to them that they should, on the other hand, be pleased and happy that their employees are independent, are prepared to express their views. I am absolutely certain that the employers will take note of this fact, that if really there are cases of victimization, or there are going to be cases of victimization, and if I am convinced that there has been victimization because they appeared before the commission, I shall try to use my best office to see that the victimization is not resorted to. The resolution which my friend has brought forward is one near to my own heart, and I can assure him that irrespective of the attitude I may have to adopt for practical reasons, my sympathies are wholly with the resolution. I have intimately known generalists ever since I started my own public career, and I have had lifelong interest in the welfare of the working classes in general in our country. Stop.